right, everybody. This is Shelby Reynolds with the Naples Daily News. I'm going to hope that signal sticks around here. I am in East Naples, right off of Collier Boulevard and US 41, where crews from FPL are working to restore power here at this mobile home park and to some nearby neighborhoods to the south of us. I'm just going to scan here. As you can see, there's a wooded area back there that crews had to come in and clear out some trees and other brush before workers could get in here to fix these lines. But with me here, I have Bill, who is a spokesperson for FPL, and he's going to tell us a little bit about what they're doing here today and give us an update on power in Collier County. Bill, will you tell us what they're doing here today?
Sure. So we have crews working throughout Collier County. Actually, we have about 2,300 men and women on the West Coast getting the lights back on to some of our hardest hit areas in our service territory. What you see here is a crew. They are working on putting this neighborhood line back up, a neighborhood power line that serves not only this mobile home park, but a neighborhood to the east or west. Once that's done, hopefully by tonight, they will be able to get their power restored. So the process has been slow because now we're going into some of the hardest hit areas where tree damage, other debris have gone into our lines, brought down power lines, brought down poles, and our crews are working safely and round the clock to get everyone's lights back on.
Tell us about the crews that you have. They're coming from all over the country, I understand, and tell us where they're staying at, how long they're working. I understand they're working very hard.
Sure. So we have a total workforce of 27,000 men and women, and they come from 30 states throughout the country and also Canada, as far north as New York and as far west as California. And we pre-staged them before the storm so they could safely restore power once it was safe to do so, once the winds had died down and the roads were clear. So these men and women, they live at one of our staging sites. We have 20 set up throughout the state. There's one at the Collier County Fairgrounds and also at the racetrack at Bonita. And these act like mini cities where our crews get their work orders, their trucks, their equipment, they get their gas, and they go out into the field, they do their work, they come back, they get their meals, they get to shower, do their laundry, and sleep there with bunkers that we have set up. We can sleep about 1,000 crew members at each staging site. So by doing this and having this staging site activity, it gets our men and women back into the field quicker to get the lights back on.
Interesting. Will you talk about post-storm, what that process is? You told me about sort of the priorities, infrastructure priorities post-storm. What comes first right after Irma had passed?
Sure. So our main method of getting the lights back on is to bring on the largest number of customers in the shortest amount of time. First, we have to make sure our power generating plants and our transmission lines are all operating. They bring power down to the substations, which distribute it into the neighborhoods and local communities. So we have worked with our community partners in each county that we work with to set priorities. And those priorities are getting the hospitals, 911 centers, police and fire stations, critical facilities that are needed in each community, and also services that community relies upon, gas stations, grocery stores, and pharmacies, to be up and running quickly once the storm passes. While we're doing that, we're bringing up thousands of customers along the way. And then, as you see here today, we're in our hardest hit areas where we're going literally block by block and sometimes house by house, getting the lights back on for our customers.
I think the latest numbers show that 72% of FPL customers in Collier County have been restored. The latest date you said was the 22nd is when you hope to have customers back on. Should people, or is that on track as far as?
That's correct. We hope that many of our customers will be able to get their lights back on before then. Certainly, Collier County was one of the hardest hit counties by Irma. A lot of tree and wind debris damage. Also, a lot of flooding. So in areas where there may have been some tornado activity or severe flooding, that may hamper our efforts to meet that deadline. But we believe we will have essentially everyone restored by the 22nd. And we ask for your patience as we continue our hard work to get that done.
Thank you. Yeah, and like we talked about, a lot of, you know, residents are frustrated, they don't have power back on. What can you say to them as they're, you know, waiting in the dark?
Well, we know how difficult it is to be without power, even for a few short hours, let alone days or now a week. But as you can see behind me, there are crews working around the clock to get everyone's lights back on. So we ask for your patience, and we also ask for safety above all else. There's a few things you can do in terms of safety. Ensure that when you're cleaning up around your house, make sure you're away from any power lines that may be down, stay far away. And if you're doing any yard work or clearing up, make sure you're at least 10 feet away from any power lines that are overhead. Also, treat intersections that don't have power as a four-way stop. If you have appliances on, major appliances, you should turn those off before the lights come back on. Maybe keep one light on in a living room or a den so you can see when your power gets restored. And stay away from anything that's flooded. You never know what's underneath and it could be dangerous. So that's what we really want our customers to do, is have patience. And we appreciate the patience we've received from customers, but also be safe above all else.
Awesome. And then just to recap, tell us again what crews are doing right now. I hear some cheering. It sounds like something good just happened.
Yeah, so crews are repairing this power line. There's one of the lines of this three-phase system that are down. The crews are getting that back up. They will connect it onto the main line and Tamiami Trail. And once they do that, this mobile home park and the neighborhood nearby, this wooded area, will get their power back on, hopefully by tonight.
Awesome. Okay, well, thank you so much, Bill, for your time, and best of luck to you guys.
You're welcome. Thank you.